Washington Pod presents Earl Nightingale.
Successful people come in all ages, shapes, sizes, and colors, but they all have one thing in common, a winning attitude. The attitude we habitually present to the world can be controlled by you and me. We determine our attitude when we get up in the morning and set out on a new day. And our days, all the years of our lives, will usually reflect and give us back what we really expect. We live in a world of words. No matter what something happens to be, we have a word for it. And some words mean a great deal to us. Words such as love, happiness, success, achievement, joy, ability. These words describe conditions all of us want. But there's one word that controls them all. That is, there's one word that describes a condition that will bring us all of these things or keep us from getting any one of them. It's been called the most important word on earth. If your youngster asked you what this word is, could you tell him? And if from all the many thousands of words in the language you were asked to select the one that would influence your life more than any other, could you pick the right word? I call it the magic word, and I've talked about it before. In our language, it's pronounced attitude. Once we're grown and on our own, this word actually controls our environment, our entire world. You see, if your attitude toward the world is good, you'll obtain good results. If your attitude is excellent, you'll obtain excellent results. And if your attitude is just so-so, well, you'll live in a world that is not particularly bad nor particularly good, just so-so. Now, if you're curious about what kind of an attitude you have, a simple test will tell you what your attitude's been up to this point in your life. Just answer this question with a yes or no. Do you feel the world is treating you well? If your answer is a quick yes, your attitude is good. If your answer is no, your attitude is bad. And if you have trouble deciding, your attitude is probably average. You see, our environment, which is another way of saying how the world treats us, is nothing more than a reflection, a merciless mirror, actually, of our own attitude. One of the most pitiful aspects of society is the really large percentage of people who lead dismal, narrow, darkened lives, crying out against what appears to be a cruel world that they believe has singled them out for an existence of trouble, misery, and bad luck. Our attitude will determine whether we tend to be lucky or not. People who expect to be lucky, who expect good things to happen to them more often than bad, actually go through life from one piece of good fortune to another. I know there are cynics who don't believe all of this, but it's true all the same, and it's been proved hundreds of thousands of times. It doesn't mean you can pick the winner at the track or bet on the right team. There are too many variables in such things. But we get from life what we tend to expect from it. We do the things we make up our minds to do, live in the towns or areas we want to live in, and work at the jobs of our choice once we learn the magic of putting our minds and attitudes to work in our lives. The person with the attitude that he can't do something will seldom do it. The person who believes he can does. Perhaps not the first time, but his attitude gives him the confidence to stay with it until it's been accomplished. When I was starting out to build my business, I used to call on advertising agencies in Chicago. I met a lot of receptionists and telephone operators. I'd give my greeting and ask how they felt, and I recall hearing on several occasions, in fact most of the time, the response, "I'm tired." I'd say, "Well, it's only 10 o'clock in the morning. How can you be tired already? No sleep last night?" "No," the receptionist would say, "I got plenty of sleep. I'm just tired in the mornings." These people had tired attitudes. They expected to be tired, but if they were leaving on vacation that morning or a special weekend were coming up, chances are they'd get up feeling great. Nearly every time I've started something of some size and risk, I've had people tell me not to try. "You'll just lose your shirt," they'd say. They had losing attitudes. I never gave it a thought, and you'll find that typical of people who get things done. They may proceed with great caution and care and go to great lengths to avoid making any unnecessary mistakes. But they fully intend to win, and when they do, with an attitude of failure, we're whipped before we start. Successful people come in all ages, shapes, sizes, and colors, but they all have one thing in common, a winning attitude.